Why was Alfred's game so much more successful than Alfred's other game? And that is Alfred, who is quite
Scrabble.
Well... Yes, Scrabble is the answer. Alfred Butts is
and
name.
And he sold out for bugger all.
Well, it was an interesting story. He had the idea of the board and the 15 by 15 squares and the triple letter and double word and so on. And he made them himself. And in the early 50s, it was around in the shops of New York and it was a great success. But it just so happened the chap who ran Macy's, the famous department store, he played it one Christmas and he went nuts for it. Absolute nuts for it. And the following year, it sold 4 million. It was the fastest and biggest growing game in the history of that genre of games. It just completely went wild. And all he got, I say all, was about $1,600,000, Butts, the inventor. But he never complained about it. He said, it's perfectly fine. It allowed me to have a wonderful life, and he was proud of it. But he then produced another game, which he called Alfred's Other Game. and that, unfortunately, wasn't a hit, despite the lady in the black busty dress. The principle of the scoring is pretty obvious. He used the, you know, the frequency of letters in English. The highest possible score you could have from one word has been worked out. I wonder if you know what that word might be. It seems unlikely.
Well, it depends if you're adding. The highest I ever got was underpass on two triple word scores.
That's very good. I did bezique once and got sort of 200.
Yes, you
200.
Would.
No, that was very nice.
You would do underpass, though,
wouldn't you?
Underpass is good. All words.
Well, you've got to use all seven because you get the plus 50.
Yes, you've got to get the 50. But the most irritating thing about playing Scrabble with people is when they use words that aren't in common usage, that are in... They just, back in the early this year, they announced that GRRL is now a word, but it isn't.
No, it isn't. And I basically have my house rule, which is you can't use a word you don't know the meaning of. I just don't think it's
fair. No, I'll go even further.
Some people just learn lists of words.
Okay.
People, well, why do it? You know, why put in a word that you
do
just...
Do you let people have the list of two-letter words on the show?
No. Joe is a classic case in point. I know it means love, but I never use the word Joe in conversation. Therefore, you can't have it. Or people who spell axe in the American way.
Without the E.
It's just no.
Do you know the most commonly played word in Scrabble?
Penis.
No.
It is in my house.
it's rather thrilling.
Gay?
No, not gay.
It's a good word.
It's a fine
seven,
word.
Seven.
Even more
thrilling. 7 points.
QI. QI, thank you very much. Key is the most commonly played word in Scrabble. It's because it's a Q that doesn't need a U. And you can just put it next to an I, and if it's on a triple letter, you're immediately scoring
well. Yes, but
well.
It's not.
It's the Chinese for the life force, as you know. Well, if you could possibly play the word, and obviously it would involve intersecting with many other words, because it's longer than seven letters. If you could get oxyphenylbutazone, there is a technical potential score of 1,178. Just for playing that.
And I bet you've done it.
I've never played that.
Is this called my bluff? Or
no.
Can
no.
I just point out, right?
The
I'm dyslexic. I've never played Scrabble. To me, playing Scrabble is essentially like decorating a bathroom.
Oh, yeah.
Finished.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.